Hello, everybody, and welcome to my Nut Hut. It's Shug here. I'm preparing for a little one-night trip that I'm going to leave for tomorrow morning here in Minnesota. We got a little bit of snow yesterday. It's cold. It's going to get down to maybe 2 degrees, maybe zero up where I'm going. Just getting out for a quick one-nighter. And then we're going to talk a little bit about the food I bring on the trail. And I'll tell you this right now. I don't really do anything special food-wise. I'm lazy. I go with pretty simple freeze-dried and dehydrated backpacking meals. Well, let me have some coffee and we'll get into it and talk about it. How's that sound? I love to have me breakfast from the hammock in the morning. Me breakfast from the hammock is my whole reason for going backpacking. Honestly, it is. I usually put my breakfast, each breakfast individually packed in a baggie like this. And this is just one of the Ziploc freezer bags. Standard breakfast for me. I'll have one of my coffees right here. That is my Medaglia d'Oro instant espresso coffee. And I sort of just put it in a little pouch like that. And what that is I take these baggies, the old style baggie that your mama probably put your peanut butter and jelly sandwich in. So I take one of these baggies. These are old classic baggies. They don't have the fancy plastic closure top. You actually bag this up with the old-fashioned twist tie. So it's your twist tie baggie. And this is just basically how I make my coffee. I'll take my Medaglia d'Oro, pour myself a big fat ounce of it like that. And that's just a container I got off a cough syrup thing. That's about a fat ounce. I twist it up like that. Put my little twist tie around it. I don't need that little extra plastic on the end. And then I just take the scissors and I cut off that little bit of extra plastic, and that's what I'm left with right there. So I basically have in my breakfast pouch my one Medaglia d'Oro coffee. Yes, I like Pop-Tarts. I don't eat Pop-Tarts at home, but I certainly love them on the trail. I mark these, that's a pack of peanut butter chocolate Pop-Tarts. If I'm going on a really long trip like I do with Hickory sometimes, I might Pop-Tart it every other day, because Pop-Tarts are kind of heavy. And I've also been known to break my Pop-Tarts open and individually wrap them and just have one a day. Because believe me, after having Pop-Tarts on the trail for about 4 or 5 days, you actually get kind of sick of them. I have myself a napkin. Actually, this is just two halves of a paper towel. And I'm normally, my breakfast is probably my messier meal. So I have two select-a-size paper towels in there. And then those are ready to go to clean my pot with. Got my coffee. Usually on a trip, I would then have like what I like a lot. I just either like oatmeal, and one of my favorites is your Quaker peaches and cream oatmeal right there. I'll either throw two of those in, or Packet Gourmet West Memphis grit souffle. I'm pretty much oatmeal or grits for most morning, because I'm just sitting back in my hammock. The most important thing is my coffee and Pop-Tarts. But tomorrow what I'm doing is I cooked up some pancakes this morning. And in this, I have this double pouch. I have about 4 pancakes in there that are pre-buttered. My syrup is in there. I have about 3 slices of well-cooked bacon. And I do a lot of times bring me some cooked bacon on the trail. You know, you can get that shelf-stable bacon that'll last, but once you open it, you gotta refrigerate it. It's always a little bit floppy for me. It's never cooked. I like my bacon cooked really crispy. And remember, cooked meat does not go bad as quickly as meat that is not cooked. So when you really cook your bacon, you know, it's good in your pack, honestly. All right, I'm just gonna put a disclaimer on this, but I've been known to carry bacon for 3 or 4 days. And I don't have it out in the direct sunlight. I keep it in my pack and crumble it up in my grits, and I've never been sick from it, but that's just me. So tomorrow what I'm gonna do is take these pancakes, and I'm gonna put these down in some boiling water in my hillbilly pot and try to warm them up and have pancakes that way. Packet Gourmet makes some really good pancakes, but you gotta get up and mix the batter and everything. And honestly, I don't wanna come out of the hammock. So I just wanna get these, boil them, and eat them right there. And I've tried the frozen pancakes and they're just rubbery. I wanna see how these are. I just wish somebody would come up with a really decent pancake that's already got the butter and syrup on it that you can just drop in hot water, heat it up, take it out, and eat it. We'll see how that goes, and you'll be right there with me. Believe you me. That's my breakfast. And if I'm on a 3-day trip, then I'll have three of these. But this is just a one night, so one breakfast. But lunch is always the, I think, the hardest thing to figure. So what I normally do, I call it my Halloween bag. Because I would rather stop and have two or three or four lunches along the way. I'll have a large baggie that's got a couple of napkins in it. And I just estimate what I'm going to eat that day for lunch. Number one, and I stole this from Andrew Skirka, which is just crushed up Pringle potato chips. And normally I'm going to have those in my backpack side hip pocket. So I can stop, if I just stop to do something to film, I can get them out and have a couple of bites. And then I'm going to take something that I will consider sort of my main lunch for the day. And a lot of times for me, I like these tuna packs right here. Always satisfying to me. It could be a chunk of Spam. Well, speaking of which, there's a little can of Spam.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. That's like some fancy potted meat. Mm-hmm. Real good.
And I never eat Spam spread at home. It seems like everything I eat backpacking, I never eat at home. Only on the trail. But I gotta tell you, I like the Spam spread. It's got a little bit more spice to it. Sure, I got to carry around the little empty can, but I just crush it down with my boot, and it's not a big deal, but that makes a pretty good lunch.
And nasty, too. Something about that pork fat and parts. Mmm. There's an ear in there and a snoot and a snout.
Also in my lunch bag, I probably have a couple of packs of Justin's peanut butter. Always good energy. They're easy to slide in your pocket to have one with you. So lunch is one of those things, if I stop for one lunch, I might go, let me put a peanut butter pack in my pocket or in my waist belt pocket of my pack, and then I'm good to go if I stop and take a little break. And one of my favorite things on the trail that's just beautiful on the trail are Lutz sesame snaps. I get these at REI. It's a little sesame cracker. I mean, that's probably more than enough, but that's my little walking bag for tomorrow. And normally, lunch is one of those things where I usually have a little bit left over. I might put a couple of beef sticks in there. Oh gosh, I might add peanuts and M&Ms, but it's just a variety of things I'm estimating that I might have. Because I've got to tell you, I tried to go really lightweight one time and I was camping with people and they pull out their lunch bag with all kind of stuff. And man, I would have like nothing. And it's disheartening for everybody to be smacking on stuff around you and you got no food. One other thing I like to do in my lunch bag is add myself a coffee. So oftentimes, one of my favorite afternoon coffees is the G7 coffee, right? I order these online. Used to be able to get them through Packet Gourmet. It's a Vietnamese coffee, and I'll put one of those in there because there's nothing nicer than stopping for a little lunch break, maybe your second one, popping the stove out real quick, which is the reason I like carrying it on my side pocket. Get it right out, put about a half an ounce of alcohol in there, boil up some hot water, have a cup of hot coffee on the trail, and just enjoy the moment. I mean, just regard the moment. That is a glorious thing. So I love doing that. My favorite kind of day backpacking is a day where I walk a lot of miles. And honestly, I'm just not into cooking on the trail. I think if I was canoeing more or something, I might. And God, when somebody is cooking on the trail, believe me, I'm envious. Or when I look at videos where people are cooking sausages and potatoes, I'm envious. But I sort of go with a backpacker's way of doing it. And honestly, other than the candy bars, the food is not the main intent of my trip. The main intent of my trip is, okay, well, let me take that back. Breakfast from the hammock, or should I say, my medaglia d'oro from the hammock. Sleeping in that hammock for several hours, and just being out in the wild. That's just kind of what the trip is about. So another thing I carry in my pack, this is sort of just my daily pantry, I call it. And this little baggie I've had forever, and this I keep, that's just some pepper, just black pepper that I like to have. That napkin's probably been on 20 trips with me. It always stays in there. I have a little bit of Texas Pete hot sauce in that container for my grits. Little different things end up in there. I've got a little yellow mustard pack there. That's that fancy Gulden's mustard. You never know when some mustard's gonna come in handy. I have this little packet of HP sauce that I keep. And you never know when you need some HP sauce, and I treasure this, and I have that. I have a little pack of sriracha sauce. I don't know why I'm taking it out. I got a couple of cocos, because I'll probably drink a couple of cocos while hanging around tomorrow, and one apple cider. Because it's going to be cold, and I know I'm going to want some hot drinks. And that's just kind of my pantry, and it's nice to have an extra cocoa in case you run into somebody and you're sipping a cocoa and they don't have a cocoa and you can offer them a cocoa. And it's just a chance to say cocoa more. Now for dinner. So dinner, I take a larger 1 gallon bag. A couple of napkins in there. One for cleaning the pot, one for cleaning me. I normally want dinner to be easy. And I really like Packet Gourmet. Packet Gourmet is a food company that makes backpacking food. They're down in Austin, Texas. I really enjoy their food. I just think Packet Gourmet stuff is tastier. They make it right there in Austin. They weave dreams into it. I will have this chicken and dumplings. The day that I know that's in my food bag, I'm quite excited for dinner. I usually bring a candy bar, but I'm having the Mexican chocolate mousse. What this is a dark chocolate espresso bean mousse. Mmm. So that's dinner for me. So basically a day for me is a dinner bag set up like this. My lunch bag, which will normally, for the most part, go in the top of my pack. Everything else is gonna go in my ersack here. So when I stop, I can just grab that out and not have to dig out my whole food bag. But a normal day is gonna be dinner, a breakfast, and what's always riding in my food bag is my pantry bag with my pepper, couple of cocos, couple of coffees in there, things I'm gonna need for every meal, some hot sauce. This is an ersack with an hop sack liner, which is supposed to be smell proof, but you know what? I never even closed mine up. I basically put it in there just to kind of keep the food a little drier. And I keep all my food in the ersack. And I'm gonna put the link for the ersack below this video. It's a bear-proof bag. You can get it with a metal liner that'll go inside, but all I do is I go off and just tie this off on a tree at night. Once I've got all my food in there, and if you pack it carefully, you know, I can get 4 to 5 days of food in there depending on the meal. The longer the trip, the more I have to sort of pare the meals down. You seal it up, and they have a certain way of tying it up. And you get that thing tied up, you cinch it off tightly here, because really part of it is keeping rodents out, keeping mice out and stuff. And then you just go off and just with a square knot, tie this off on a tree. You don't have to hang it up high. If a bear comes along, he can smash and paw your food. I always look at it this way. At least he's attacking my bag and not me. My bag is usually hung a pretty good ways from me, 100 to 200 yards away, and I like that I can just go tie it off on a tree. I don't have to throw a line up, because honestly, if you know me, half the time when I threw my line up and pulled my food up in the tree, I'd look at it and go, a bear could totally get that if he wanted. So I use the ersack, and that's basically what I do for food, and I know it's probably disappointing to a lot of you, because there's not that much to it. You know, sometimes in the lunch bag too, I like to do some olives with Reggiano cheese or some sliced salami or pepperoni. Whatever the mood is, just kind of a grab bag of things that are quick to eat and easy to carry on the trail, I'll put in the lunch bag. That's about it. See you there. Bam! All secure in Sector 7. Woo, buddy! Mm-hmm.